you don't want to alienate an audience. Absolutely. Like as much as it's important to be young, you don't want to. I think with our show, we have the potential to not just reach the Gen Z.
And when it comes to friendship, there is some dil involved in that. Mm. So there's not much logic, especially when you're growing up, you know, and you just want to stay together and you just want to make an effort to keep the friendship alive.
True.
So in an effort to do that or in a bid to do that, sometimes you lie, sometimes you do things that may not be the smartest things to do.
Yeah.
But you just want to keep the friendship going.
This show is made for everybody. You can watch it with your family, you can watch it with your partner, you can watch it with your friends.
Yeah.
So that's what the show is about, and I think the essence of everything lies in the script, the way it's written, the way it's shot. So I think I have to give credit to them, because even if there are some things that the older people must be like, "Ye kya bol rahe hai?" But it's cute or it's funny or there's an explanation, you know. And for that, watch Dil Dosti Dilemma.
You know, a while ago, I was getting so sus that I'll always be mid, you know, when it comes to these social media jargons and Gen Z slangs. But I saw the Prime Video ki Dil Dosti Dilemma ke glimpses dekhe, and I knew it's so giving, man. I mean, this cast and everyone else, they have got the riz. Well, agar aap sabko ye sun ke aisa lag raha hai ki I'm just another wannabe trying to fit in, you're absolutely right.
I think you have to clap for great.
Thank you.
Very nice, Kunal.
Beautiful homework.
Thank you so much.
You raised it up.
That's the max I can go probably. But yeah, thank you guys. Thank you. This is Kunal. You're watching me on IWM Buzz. And of course, we have the fantastic team of Dil Dosti Dilemma with us. Welcome, guys.
Thank you.
All right, great. I have to start with you, Debbie, of course. You know, it's fascinating. I'm sure mere jaise bahut sare log hai, you know, out there who just probably trying to fit in. And maybe, you know, some of those people who are trying to make it somewhere, especially in the influencer world. I mean, of course, you would know it. So, you know, but when you make a show like this, it's always a factor ke kitna include kar sakte hai where it doesn't get annoying, where it doesn't, you know, start being annoying that, okay, fine, I get it, move on with it. And when you made a show like this, what was the kind of thing that you made sure ke yahan tak is the kind of barrier I put?
When it comes to
inclusion of these slangs and, you know, all the whole Gen
Z. Oh,
yeah.
Yes. Mm. Oh, okay. So, sorry, I didn't understand that. I was like, what is the question, sir?
Not a problem.
Yeah, so, yeah, no, for me, it was always add the slang, but so long as it's universal. Mm. So, the minute more than 5-6 people go, wo kya hota hai? You're like, nahi, don't.
Yeah.
Because you don't want to alienate an audience. Yeah. Like, as much as it's important to be young, you don't want to. I think with our show, we have the potential to not just reach the Gen Z. Half the shit he said in his intro, I didn't understand.
Exactly.
I will explain
what is mid. I'm like, am I midding? So I think our show has the potential to reach not just young adults, but also parents, also grandparents.
Yes.
And I don't want at any point a parent to be watching going like, oh, ye to bachcho ka show hai, kyunki mere ko nahi pata hai riz kya hota hai, ya mid kya hota hai. So, I think language exists to be able to not put up barriers rather than bring them down. And so, never use anything that would put up a barrier.
Absolutely. I have to add to this and give credit to our writers also, because the way the script is written, it doesn't feel alienating to anybody. It's so gender fluid, age fluid, that everybody who's watching the show, it's easy for you to understand. Like, this show is made for everybody. You can watch it with your family, you can watch it with your partner, you can watch it with your friends.
Yeah,
so
true.
That's what the show is about, and I think the essence of everything lies in the script, the way it's written, the way it's shot. So I think I have to give credit to them, because even if there are some things that the older people must be like, "Ye kya bol rahe?" But it's cute or it's funny or there's an explanation, you know. And for that, watch Dil Dosti Dilemma.
We're gonna keep plugging in as much as possible.
No, but that's true. You have to see the show to get what I'm trying to say.
And the biggest litmus test is on a set, right?
As much as you're laughing, you want your producer to be laughing.
You want the cast to be laughing. You also want your spot boy to be laughing. You also want your camera attendant to be laughing or crying or feeling the emotion. And that,
I think,
for us too, we had a set full of people who gave us opinions on what
was
happening.
We had an audience. It was like
great.
The show got tested
even before it got tested.
Amazing.
The cast is teenagers to the oldest, to the most senior, most actor, Shishir sir, Suhasini Mule ma'am. And I mean, we don't know their age. I mean, there's a there's a big
there's a gap
huge generation gap. So I think we fit in, this show fits in perfectly because there's everything,
there's something for everyone.
There's
something for everyone.
Har cheez ka kuch kuch hai.
Every generation kuch hai. And there are Revati Pillai.
You know, everyone's going to find it relatable.
Yeah, it's perfect. Yeah, it's perfect when you mention relatable.
The Gen Z or the youngsters are true to what they are or what their problems are. It's very real. But at the same time, I feel even the older cast members or the older characters, everything, the way it's written, it's very true to their characters.
True.
That's why it becomes relatable and real.
Absolutely. I think that is one of the biggest reasons we all said yes to the...
That's why.
Yeah.
True. And
it's going to have a crazy impact on the kids and the elderly.
You will find comfort in it.
In a way that, you know, it's going to bring everyone closer to each other.
Yeah. Very true.
Impact of friendships
and
relationships.
You know, the children and the grandparents are going to come closer to each other.
Yeah.
Everyone's going to be having more
children
things to talk
parents
about.
Also.
Parents also. Everyone's going to come closer together. You know.
And brothers and sisters also.
More things to talk to each other about.
Perfect, fantastic.
Brothers and sisters also. Anyway, sorry.
No, absolutely. No, you're right. Yeah. Because, you know, it's amazing you mention all these words, especially relatable being the key word for me. Because I've happened to see 3 episodes and it's exactly, you know,
How are you all watching this?
Yeah, I want to know. They have been.
It's all a mystery.
Let's, Revati, we will take
it.
It's
a hota
hai.
No, but exactly, you know, I get to that because, you know, exactly kind of what I relate to, because it's exactly the way you have that feeling, okay, everything is very relatable.
Mm. Yeah.
But, you know, on that line, especially I have to open this question to the 3 of you, because you all obviously play the awesome threesome, you know, the great, it's so amazing the kind of camaraderie you all have.
Yes.
And at the same time, you know, also having that very rich, spoiled, you know, vibe to the, you know, themselves. I have to ask you that. I'm sure there might be an explanation here in the episodes, but where everything else, you know, you are trying to ape something, you're trying to ape a life and it's not being real with your friends for a while.
Yeah.
How is it that, you know, 3 people who are so rich, so spoiled in their own senses, but somehow have this very real friendship with each other, and what makes it so real?
I think that's what friendship is all about, no? Like, with this friendship, you don't see how rich they are or how what's the money status, what they do. If people get along, they just get along. No matter where they're from, what they do, it doesn't really matter. I think that's why the way they're all friends with each other, because their personalities, they're very different from each other, but there's some similarities and they just, you know, they just flow together. They complement each other. Of course, there's some flaws. They're also growing up. They're like 18, 19 years old. We're all growing up. No matter what age you are in, you're always learning, unlearning when you're growing up. So nobody's perfect. They have their own flaws. You might find them like, array, they're being a little snooty, they're being a little, you know, snobby towards somebody or some particular situation. But you have to also see that they're just girls who are just growing up in a world where, you know, they also have pressures. It doesn't mean that if you're rich, everything is easy for you. Of course, you have your own challenges, you're fitting in. Asmara's whole thing, why she's trying to lie, you'll see more in the show, but it's because she just wants to fit in. And that pressure, I'm sure people who are watching, they understand. And there's a certain pressure. You're like, I will lose my friends if I'm not a certain way.
Right.
But that's not true. They will love her the way she is. And that's why the friendships are supposed to be like that. You're supposed to have friends.
They will stay no matter what.
Yeah, you should have friends like that. And your circle should be people who will support you no matter who you are and where you're from.
True. Both of you as well. Because, you know, you all also have very interesting character arcs yourselves.
And I feel like, to add to what Anushka said, sometimes it could be, the reason could be that, you know, you're wanting to fit in or your friends will leave you. But other times, for like for Tanya, it could be something as simple as, you know, I don't want to involve them in this or give them, have them also take the pressure of what I'm facing right now. You know, I'll deal with it and then I'll tell them what happens.
That happens.
You know, there can be different reasons at that age. And when it comes to friendship, there is some dil involved in that. So there's not much logic, especially when you're growing up. You know, and you just want to stay together and you just want to make an effort to keep the friendship alive. So in an effort to do that or in a bid to do that, sometimes you lie, sometimes you do things that may not be the smartest to do.
Yeah.
But you just want to keep the friendship going.
True.
I think Naina, Tanya and Asmara complement each other. You know, there is that group which always had that one level-headed person, one brat and one who's like, okay. You don't do this, you don't do that. So I am always that, what, where, how? So that, I am exactly who I am playing. I am, even now, like before the interview, we were discussing the same thing. Debbie was like, "Kuch bhi ho jaye, Revati ko bolenge. Everything's fine."
And Revati is also like, "Haan,
haan." Yeah, I'm like, "Haan, theek hai, chalega." I'm always like that. She's the one who's like, "Haan, nahi, nahi, kar lenge." She's like, "Listen. Yeah. What is wrong with you?" She'll be like putting everybody in place. Nahi, ye galat hai, ye sahi. And she'll be like, "Nahi, kar lenge. And I'm like, "Haan, idhar ye." And so it's always so that.
We
so
got
it's,
it. We got it.
Yeah, it's that's the beauty of their friendship.
See now see? Again. See?
We got it. Like,
three times she's doing that. That's our dynamic.
Of course.
Awesome threesome.
Right. And of course, coming to you, Kush, you know, I mean, you play the ideal good boy. You know, I mean, that's the kind of, I think, you know, one of those marks. I'm abhi aage aur change hua to mere ko nahi pata. That is not on me for sure. But so far, you know, he's like this very ideal good boy.
Yeah.
Mummy ko pasand aane wala, sabke maa ko, and ladkiyon ko bhi obviously pasand aane wala. You know, but when you play something, I'm sure if whatever the arc is later, but when you play something like this, how is it that you make sure that it never gets vanilla? You know, I'm sure there's a lot credit, you know, to the writing and the way it's directed. But, you know, it's, such characters can be very vanilla after a point of time. So, is there something that you make sure or is just very in the flow moment?
It's mostly in the flow. Again, the writing has been such that Farzan as a character has had a certain set of life that he's been through, and how he meets Asmara and how things shape up after that is completely fresh and new to him. You know, everything's happening. He's never felt like that before.
Aww.
And it's happening beautifully. Yeah. So he's discovering his own arc, as
yeah.
you said.
Yes.
And you very rightly mentioned the boy who is liked by everybody and who is favored by everybody. He as a character himself is something just like that, you know. He caters to that those kind of people who he's not expecting anything in return. He's a giver.
Correct.
You know, so also very relatable. I have connected to this character a lot personally. So the vanilla aspect of it, it's very in control, you know, and also in the flow. Can't really explain that to you.
Can
but,
I add on
please,
this?
Please.
Because as Asmara, because I see a different point of view from my perspective, Farzan is not your vanilla boy. He's not. There's
okay,
so many
yeah.
layers to him. No,
yeah,
that
I
is
agree.
Just so beautiful. It's like the arc that he has in the show. It's not like this, it's like that
yes.
because as people, like I mentioned, that we all have our own journeys,
yeah,
we all
fact,
grow.
I like the fact that you asked that question because it's good,
it's important
first
to know.
Three episodes,
yeah.
I like that you think he's vanilla,
right.
yeah.
There is a lot that
there's
gets
lot
revealed
that changes.
About
yeah.
Yeah. There's
so
a lot that gets revealed that's revealed about these three,
yeah.
there's a lot that gets
yeah.
revealed about their.
So, there's
sure.
layers.
So, everything that you think. Right now,
yeah.
it's
going to
be probably lopsided.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean,
I mean,
yeah, it doesn't get lopsided.
But I would say everybody is, you know, imperfectly perfect.
But there's a reason
ways.
Why right
Correct.
Now the, it's all intentional. Like,
but
you're
like, are you vanilla? Just a question.
You tell me.
No, not
wow, Revati.
I'm very much the same actually.
He's not, I'm sure.
In real life, he's black curry. She just said, like, in real life, he's black curry.
Who said that?
Revati.
Revati. Where's Adbhut?
Oof.
Adbhut.
Most Adbhut thing
she's seen.
Oh, amazing.
No,
course,
they will
amazing.
You start in 5 minutes.
So that's why if you watch the show, then you'll know.
Of course,
yeah.
I will.
They'll those the dilemma on Amazon Prime.
Yes.
Yeah. Every 25th April.
And of course, you know, coming to Vishakha, it is amazing. You know, she's the live wire.
Oof.
And
oof.
It was
fire.
Relatable, real, fun. You just keep, you know, having that feel consistently.
You just love her.
Yeah, yeah. She's
yeah.
just adorable. She's
yeah.
one of those people
you
just adore.
You have no choice but to love Rukhsana.
Absolutely.
Rukhsana is one of those people that you have no choice
yeah.
but.
Ruru
yeah.
and Vishakha both.
Like,
true.
If you don't like
true.
Her, what's wrong with
what's
you?
What's wrong with you? Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, absolutely.
And what's amazing is that, you know, you in real life is probably more towards, you know, the whole awesome threesome or maybe, you know, like a more social media fanatic as everybody is. So it's amazing that, you know, you're able to crack something like that. What was the most real aspect about all these things that, you know, spoke the most to you?
I think Rukhsana is a bit like me,
hmm.
kind
yeah.
of, as they always
yeah.
told.
Yeah,
yeah.
Abhi thodi shant dikh rahi ho, pata nahi.
Aaj to main se glam avatar bhi aayi.
So she's like,
that
actually very
good.
she's very Ruru. Even with the poise and the elegance that she
and
actually
it's funny
has, by the way.
The, because she's actually the person she is in life is who she had to play on screen. Like if she ever, in fact, there were things where I would be like, how would Vishakha say it like that? Mm. You know, yes. don't try to be Ruxana.
Right.
Be yourself because that's who she is. So, you know.
Perfect.
Say more things, cute things.
But no, how did you feel when you were playing Ruru? Because I think it's such a beautiful, fun character. What did you feel like as an actor? How was it like for you to portray it?
Yeah, so
I wanna know.
Starting me when Devi was taking my workshops, she was like, Vishakha, you have to control your emotions, because sometimes Ruxana will control her emotions. Okay, I have to work on that. She was like, mirror mein dekho and just control yourself. Okay, I will talk like this for a time.
She has a, Ruxana and Vishakha, see, now they're the same person in my head. Vishakha has a habit of going this
I just move my head a lot.
So literally I would stand with her holding her head. I'm like, don't move it.
She was like literally holding my face like this. Don't move. Now say your line.
But I had so much fun working with her. Yeah. I mean, I did with everyone. But because our personalities are so different in the show. Like she's like we both are very energetic, but in a very different way. Two different energies together. It was like it could have been very chaotic. But it was not. So I love performing.
Yes.
Learned a lot.
But she was the one, I was like very nervous because this is my first show. मैं कर पाऊंगी कि नहीं मैं बट आई गॉट सच अमेजिंग को एक्टर्स एंड आई वाज लाइक ये हो जाएगा
अमेजिंग एंड आई हैव टू मेंशन डेबी पुष्पा प्लीज वन ऑफ माय फेवरेट शोज ऑफ ऑल टाइम
गो डेबी
एंड टू हैव सुमुखी डू दैट ओ माय गॉड
Thank you.
It was adorable. I'm a huge Sumukhi Suresh fan, and to see her doing what she does in the first episode, it's hilarious. It just set the tone right away.
Thank you.
It's fantastic.